Hey Measure Nerds, David here from Measure School, and today I'm going to do something a little bit different. I'm going to talk about why a local small business owner should have Google Analytics installed and how it will help their website be more successful. If you follow all the way to the end, we are also going to give away our Google Slides so that you can use this presentation at a small business networking event if you want to. So let's get right into it. As stated in my introduction, today's video is called Why Do Businesses Need Google Analytics? And I think it's important to understand what we're going to cover here today is that we're going to look at the reasons that a local small business owner should install Google Analytics and what are some of the best uses of Google Analytics to help that small business owner be more successful in their local market. And right now, I think that there's a love-hate relationship with Google. I know a lot of people understand that Google brings them a lot of business and that they need Google, but they also sometimes feel tied to Google and they don't love being told what to do. Like for instance, with the new Google Analytics 4 coming out, a lot of people now have to switch from Universal over to GA4, and that's caused quite a stir among business owners. But needless to say, what you have to realize is that really Google's goal with Google Analytics is to help make your website as profitable as it can be. And the reason for that is if you have a profitable website, then you are going to spend more money with Google. Pretty much they're a business like anybody else, and so they really want to give you the tools that it takes for you to be successful. So let's go into a little bit of my feelings on this. Does your company use any of these type of advertising, like review sites? Do you have Yelp and Foursquare and different ones like that? Or do you use a digital marketing campaign right now? Are you advertising on Facebook or posting on Instagram? Do you have SEO, search engine optimization? Are you trying to get your website to rank higher in Google? Are you running a pay-per-click advertising campaign? Generally, people do that with Google, but they also might do it with Bing or Yellow Pages or one of the other services that are out there. And then finally, are you advertising anywhere? Billboards, Yellow Pages, the newspaper, TV. If you do any kind of advertising along these lines, really the key to being successful with that is that you need to understand the data to be successful. Peter Drucker, who is a very famous management consultant, said you can't improve that which you don't measure. And it is really so true. And it's kind of why we started Measure School, is to help businesses so that they could measure what is successful right now. And the best way to do that is to use Google Analytics. And so there's three specific ways that analytics helps improve a small business owner's website. First is through SEO. So if you're trying to rank your website, which I think everybody is, you may not hire somebody to do it directly, but maybe you're doing it or you're trying to improve the website so that it ranks higher in Google, then SEO is just better done with Google Analytics. And so how is that? Well, I think the first reason is that it helps you find new keywords that our visitors are using. That is, let's say you're trying to rank for keyword X, but for whatever reason, people are putting keyword Y into Google and finding your website. And so, maybe that is a better keyword that you should look for. And the only way you would have ever found that out is to use Google Analytics. Next, you can see your top performing pages. You do need to know what pages are successful, which pages that have I tweaked and done things to are now ranking well, are getting people visiting them, and are making sales. And that brings us to the next point, which is to compare the organic visitors versus what is branded terms. So, for instance, we get people that type in Measure School. That's a branded term. Everybody knows us by Measure School. So that is something that we don't necessarily have to really worry about ranking. Google already knows that's us. However, what we want is people to search for Google Analytics 4 and we show up for that, or different keywords around GA4, different keywords around Data Studio. Those are non-branded terms. Those are what we would call organic terms. And so we can compare our visitors to make sure that our SEO efforts are working out. And then finally, the last one is just to track those SEO keywords and pages. You need to know, after you've made changes, has it improved? Are more people coming? And the easiest way to do that is to go into your analytics report and take a peek. It's also tied to Search Console, which means you can find what your average ranking data is in Google Analytics, and you should be able to see a graph that shows a steady improvement over time while you're doing SEO. The next reason to have Google Analytics installed is to make your PPC ads more effective. And PPC is really based on the demographics that you set it up with, meaning you need to know your clientele very well. And Google Analytics actually has a section that shows you that clientele. It tells you what their age, their gender, the device, the interest, their location, everything, so that you can target the right person with your advertising online. And that information is just so valuable and makes your advertising so much more effective. The next reason would be that it reports goals and conversions. So, and with analytics, you can say, hey, here's what I'm trying to do. Here's a goal that I have. Or when they get to this page, that is a conversion, meaning they purchased or whatever you're looking for as your conversions. Or perhaps that you're giving away a free report. That could be a conversion as well. And so when you're advertising and you're spending money to get a visitor to come over to your account, you want to know, are you reaching your goals and are you reaching your conversions? Because if you're not, then that advertising is ineffective. And I see way too many small business owners decide to spend money on, you know, ads and have no idea if they're working. They're not tracking them correctly. And they just assume, well, I see people coming through the door, so they must be seeing my ads. And that is not being effective with pay-per-click. So definitely want to use analytics for that. And then just as a small side note, if you're doing Google Ads, Bing Ads, any sort of advertising, you always have an opportunity to say, these are keywords that I don't want. And what analytics can do, based on what people are converting or what people are hitting your goals, is can tell you, these are negative keywords. These are bad keywords. You don't want to advertise for these keywords, and you can pull those out, and it can save you an absolute ton of money as a small business owner. And then finally, the one thing that I talked to you a little bit about was digital marketing and digital marketing strategies. Google Analytics 4 definitely helps you push forward on a better strategy for your digital marketing. And there's four ways that I would like to point out that this happens. The first is to learn what social platforms to target. You can actually go into Google Analytics and find out where people are coming from. And so if you're getting like 90% of your traffic from TikTok that's going to your website, well, obviously you want to spend more time there, and you want to keep driving different videos so that people come to your website. Another way that analytics helps is to identify what channel drives buyers. Now, you don't just want traffic. You also want to know who people are purchasing when they come from. So like if Facebook is coming over and people actually purchase products through Facebook, then you want to advertise more in Facebook. You want to do more digital marketing in Facebook, and analytics will tell you that. Analytics will also help show you what content people like on your website. And that content then is what you want to put on your social media sites as well. And so your digital marketing campaigns are based on the content that people like. And so if people are enjoying your Facebook posts, or there's certain posts that do better than other posts, or pictures on Instagram do better than pictures, you know, other things, then you know what types of content to use to make your campaign more successful. And then finally, it also helps you to create cross-selling and opportunities. And so let's say somebody comes in and you're a makeup seller online, or you have a local makeup store, and they look at, you know, blushes, and then immediately after they're done with blushes, they go over and they look at lipsticks. Well, that shows you that those two maybe have a relationship, and your buyers are looking at both of those. And so on your buy pages, or you can upgrade, and you can have, hey, want to take a look at people buy these products also. So there's definitely opportunities or cross-selling opportunities that analytics is going to show you and help you with your website. So I hope that helps you. Those are the reasons that I would use Google Analytics if I was a local small business owner. Thank you very much.